As subtle as it is, you wouldn't believe how many people I see fall victim to it every single day in coding interviews. Now, let's jump into it. First and foremost, being late. That sounds so subtle and simple, right? That, like, how is that falling victim? People fall victim to their clocks, their times, all the time. And it's one of the easiest ways to make a really bad impression in the very beginning. So do not be late. If you're not early, you're late. Let's leave it at that. And as it is, you should try to show up 15 to 30 minutes early. Point being here, though, that not everyone always likes you being super early because then they have to go get you. But point is, you need to be early. Period. Don't fall victim to thinking, oh, I'll show up right on time, everything will be good. No. Second point, casual is okay. Yeah, no. And I say this because far too often people will come in and think and speak like we're best friends or like we're cool. And they think that this whole casualness is kosher when really it's not. I don't know you, you don't know me. You need to be respectful of the work environment. You need to show respect for what you're interviewing here with. And that goes also to the dress code. People think and read online, oh, it's a casual company. They wear jeans and pajamas into work. Great. Don't do it. Do not fall victim to this idea of casual is okay at these companies. You need to dress for what you want to be like and dress how you want to act and not fall victim to dressing down to how you want to be. Yeah, I get it. Once you're in the job, great. You want to wear jeans in? Fine. But now, when you're interviewing, you need to dress to impress and you need to speak to impress. And so, don't use improper grammar. Don't use slang. Be direct. Don't be vague. There's lots of little things in there. I get that. But casual is not okay. So, do not fall victim to thinking casual is okay. You don't have to wear a tuxedo by any means, but a suit and tie would help. Let's leave it at that. Now, not knowing the company, people fall victim to all the time. More often than not, whether it's a mock interview, whether I'm helping a student out, wherever I am, I ask because mock interviews generally have fake companies. I ask them about the companies. I ask them about that. And even in the mock interviews, they fall victim to it. What do you think is going to happen in a real interview when you have no idea about this company in Atlanta that's still owned by the founder, that has extreme pride in Atlanta, that really loves their culture and you know nothing about it. So don't fall victim to thinking that you are just coming to do an interview and you don't have to know the culture, you don't have to know anything about them and not knowing the company and you can just come in. Now, on the flip side, don't fall victim to not knowing your own worth. Far too often, people will come in and not realize what they're worth or talk about what they're worth. And they fall victim to this, like letting people think that they're just, oh, I'm just a developer, or I'm just an so like I'm just this one thing, and you don't know you're worth more. You're worth more as a leader in code, as a communicator, as a team player, as all these soft skills that you really are, but you don't know your own worth, so you don't portray them. And people fall victim to that time and time again. So I encourage you to know your worth. Know, and that's not just a monetary value. It's what you bring to a team. It's what you can actually do when you're in the job and what you're doing already. And lastly, don't fall victim to not saying thankful and being grateful or showing gratitude. It's not to say that the people that are you're interviewing with walk on water by any means. No. But the fact they were willing to look at your resume, bring you in, take their time out of their day to talk to you, like, time is our most precious asset. Let's be honest about it. So the fact you're not going to thank them for them taking their time, because your time might potentially change your life, but them taking their time out of their day to meet with you is huge. So don't fall victim to not saying thank you to everyone on the team that you get to interview with and show an appreciation and gratitude, because it's only going to help you be personable. These are the main things within don't fall victim to. Do not fall victim to being late. And that casual is okay, not knowing a company, not knowing your own worth, and not saying thank you. You follow those five things and it will immensely help you not fall victim to some of the most common things I see in interviews on a daily basis. Let me know your thoughts. Feel free to leave a comment and I will see you guys in the next video.